Under these circumstances, does it make it virtually impossible to have a plan B, plan C, plan D if he doesn't re-sign?
No, we do.
How do you go, you're not going to mention names, obviously, how do you go about doing that?
Well, in any event, you know, whether it's plan A or plan B, we're limited. You know, with the new collective bargaining agreement, there's just no way for us to, because of our projected financial situation, there's no way for us to add a player onto the team other than using what they call the mini-mid or the minimum salary for a player. So whether, you know, Dwight's here or he's not, what we can do to improve the team remains the same. It's not like if one player is not here, we have more resources or we have that money to use to sign another player. It doesn't work that way. So, you know, we have a plan A, we have a plan B. Plan A is always better than plan B.
Unless you get a situation like when you acquire Powell and you get a, you know, a true superstar, it almost makes it imperative for you guys to keep free agents like Dwight Howard, you know, even if you didn't want to because you can't get him anymore when you're your financial echelon like you guys are.
It's not, the hardest thing to do is to get the player to the city. That's the hardest thing to do because of the draft rights and then the rules with the advantages going to teams to keep free agency and then restricted free agency. So the hardest thing to do is to get them to the franchise, and then we'd like to keep them. You know, the good thing going forward for us is that we do have a lot of financial flexibility a year from now. So, you know, we hope to field a very competitive team next year. You know, certainly there's question marks. You know, there's Kobe, there's Steve Nash, and there's Dwight. But we think we can be a very competitive team. And then the year after that, we've got, you know, an enormous amount of financial flexibility.
You didn't mention Powell. You didn't mention Powell.
When, just now?
If the Lakers don't re-sign Dwight, does rebuilding become the new mentality of the Lakers office?
Nothing really changes. Like I said, we have the same resources to improve the team this year, which would be maybe the mini-mid and the minimum player salaries. You know, the flexibility that I'm talking about comes a year from now.